法国总统马克龙会在4月5号到7号到访中国，这是外交部发言人华春莹宣布。马克龙到访是英国家主席习近平的邀请。 同样会在4月5号到7号到访中国的是欧盟委员会主席冯德莱恩宣布这个消息的是中国外交部发言毛宁，但是这个是经中欧双方商定冯德莱恩到访中国。我们看到《金融时报》的曹新这么说，说冯德莱恩访华前线的讲话是相当强硬的，尤其使得中国不能接受的是，冯德莱恩将未来中欧关系的前景跟中国在俄乌冲突当中的表现挂钩。 青岛日报的评论这么说：放下高高在上的心态，中欧才能够真正的走近。说最近有很多的欧洲领导人到中国来访问，事实上是因为中国崛起了，才有能力推动俄乌和谈，才有能力帮助欧洲经贸。如果欧盟放不下主宰世界的利益，放不下凌驾发展中国家的心态，拒绝跟中国合作，必然是误人误己。也就是说，这些欧洲领导人到中国来，寻求的是欧洲跟中国一起来帮助。 俄乌冲突能够化解，那么我们的记者呢就访问了中国欧盟商会主席伍德克，他表示欧洲商界期待看到中欧加强高层交往。中国外交部3号宣布，法国总统马克龙和欧盟委员会主席冯德莱恩将于4月5号到7号访问中国。 中国欧盟商会主席伍德克周一在接受本台专访时说，欧洲商界欢迎中国领导人之间的互动和接触。
I think we can now see a more engagement, stronger engagement, and it's good that they overlap. That shows a strong stance and coordination on the European side, and I guess they can address a lot of topics which are very difficult to do online. So this deeper engagement post-COVID is extremely meaningful.
And what do the business community in Europe expecting from these visits?
I think our expectations are pretty low because circumstances are very difficult. Again, it might be very more political summit, but again, the business community will look on the language on technology because of the U.S.-China tech war. We will certainly look into more opening up signals from the Chinese side. And again, the big topic for all of us is some sort of speeding up on the climate change discussion. I guess that also biodiversity will be on the agenda. So for companies, I guess it will be more climate change and supply chain certainty.
伍德克预计，中欧投资协定也将是双方讨论的重点之一。协定自2020年底结束谈判后，因中欧之间的相互制裁处于搁置状态。而就在不久前，中国驻欧盟大使傅聪曾向欧方提议，双方同时解除制裁，并称只要建立在平等与互利的前提之上，中方都愿意考虑。
So do you think is there any possibilities that they will lift the sanctions at the same time?
Parliamentarians, and these are the crowd that has to ratify it, are not willing to lift it, certainly not during this period of time. They have elections next year. Maybe then the new parliament has a different attitude. This parliament, I've met them all, definitely have no appetite of approving the CAI because of the situation in Xinjiang. Mm-hmm. So again, we support the CAI, we like the CAI. In this respect, we are on common ground with Ambassador Fu. Mm-hmm. But the chances of getting this anytime soon into the ratification process, I don't see it.
虽然中欧投资协定短期内难以解冻，但伍德克认为双方可以采取积极措施扩大开放，以促进双向投资。而总体而言，他不认为欧洲的保护主义倾向正在上升，但他也坦言，欧洲在通信等事关国家安全领域所采取的措施将会给双方带来更多的不确定性，从而最终影响到全球化的进程。凤凰卫视倪晓文、赵伟，北京报道。